warm-up as we did yesterday. He's gonna start off by controlling my head. I'm gonna bridge out to my left side, so that way I can clear my head, right? And be able to at least turn and face my opponent here. He's just here. There's nothing you can do here, right? So I'm gonna bridge to hopefully get him to post his head. Boom! And it's at this moment that my hands are gonna come to the inside. My right hand comes along the waist. Right, I call it a CPR grip, that's how I used to call it. Right, my left elbow is going to come to the inside. And as my hips are still in the air, once I hunker down, I'm going to ball up into a little ball here. Alright, I want my back curved, my knees tight to my butt. I'm going to come in here nice and tight. Right, so the idea here is I'm going to start fluttering my legs. My feet are together. Right? This is the motion we're looking for. If I was on his hips, even if I was on this side, I'm doing this. Shaking, shaking, boom, and I clear that bottom knee, right? So if I was doing that CPR here, I'm going to shake, shake, my bottom knee comes through, then I can push him off, boom, get it to my single leg legs, right? That's what we're working on. And if you're choosing to use this double hip grip, it really doesn't matter at that point, because even if you had to change directions, you can still push off that one, right? But if you're doing this, you're going to have to switch your hands if they decide to push the opposite direction. Does that make sense? So if I'm doing it with my CPR grip, I'm just here, everything's on the inside, I flutter, my bottom knee clears through, then I can just clear my head, put on the head one time, right? Every time you finish, we roll all the way through to the heel, right? So this is an advanced class. By now you should kind of already sort of know this, right? So I'm gonna clear my bottom knee, right? I'll just start off because we don't have to clear the head, but I'm gonna be off to my side here. My right arm's across his hips, my left hand reinforces, and my elbow's on the inside. I'm like, my knees are close to his butt here. And this is where I start that mermaid action here. Alright? I'm pushing, trying to clear my knee through. So I'm here, boom, boom. Once my knee comes through, usually guys will pressure into you, and that's when I can deflect them. Foot goes on the hip, and then over here. Alright? Once we get here, this is how we're gonna finish. A, I don't want to do this. This, right? We expose the heel with our legs. Yeah. I catch that heel, wrist up. I make my connection. My inside leg is going to come out. And if I wanted to, I want to do like a, I would say like a triangle. I'm really lacing my feet behind my calf, pushing this far hip. So that way, as I get him to roll, boom, he ends up in that heel way. Double outside Ashi position, right? We just end that way every single time. As you roll, you're maintaining your hips up, right? So if I was rolling like this way, I get up on my head, boom, and I maintain my hips off that, right? That's what's going to stop that roll. If your hips stay on the floor, you guys just continue to roll, right? So, drop to the side here, boom, shake, shake, my knee comes through. And then as he drives into him, pull him on the deflect his hip away. Let me go right into our finisher. That makes sense? While you're drilling that, drill the bow, right? He's going to push back into you, right? Maybe you're almost clearing your knee. He felt that he starts to flatten you out. Boom! And now he's bumping to the opposite side. Just on the opposite side. Does that make sense? Alright, just add them both in there. Alright, you try to plan you out, you go from this bottom knee, and hopefully by here, you would have gotten a little bit further, and maybe you can do one flutter, boom, knee tucker. I'm on my forehead here, and I can finish the move. Does that make sense? Some of you guys are finishing up on your elbow, and that's fine, you can. But I say in that momentum, the roll is going to be hard for you to stop off the elbow. Unless you're kind of like pausing and you're trying to do it, which would give you a chance to defend the same thing, right? But as long as the heel is here, being in DOA is fine. It's the moment you get up and you don't have this, that you have that opportunity for guys to pull up and take you back. Alright, so you guys got to be very careful when you're spinning and you're letting go of this heel and it's starting up like this. Alright, it's not that safe. Alright, so we messed around with the misdirection. Let's work on just the basic elbow skin, alright? Super basic, checking the foot, getting it to happen, alright? Alright, and I'm showing this one, and this is really more for like fundamentals class, but if he was to mount me, just mount me without crossing, and not cross his feet, it's sometimes like easy to get off to your side, you know, you can track the foot, and then you turn, and then now you're in half guard, alright? That's usually like the basic way, but most guys that mount you are not going to just like leave their feet out. Sometimes they do, right? A lot of times either they're crossing their feet or just even just like pinching their feet together under your butt, and it's hard sometimes. Just even clear your knees here, right? So that simple escape of just tracking the ankle is not really always there. It's good for like the fundamental stuff to show guys how to escape across your feet, right? Where you can like sometimes just like step over, right? Or sometimes you'll see people just like grab it and they do this. See what I'm trying to say? Usually the easiest way to get this, you'll see it happen a lot, is from like when people try to knee slice through. Alright? A lot of times if he starts to knee slice, right? And you're like open up, you can catch the foot before it hits the mat. That happens a lot. And then once you're in quarter guard, you just start scooping that knee and turning the into the position to have. Alright, then you can start adjusting, right? But again, if guys are crossing their ankles, good luck. Alright? So we're going to do a version of what we did, but without that mermaid action, right? Without that kicking, right? Now we're going to bridge, and we're going to scoot our butt back hard. We're going to do a hard shoot, and then just clear our bottom knee, right? So same situation. If you would have had my hand trapped, I would have had to free it up somehow. So maybe trying to bridge this way, boom, will help us get him to base. My hands are going to come to the inside, and off that bridge, I'm going to do a hard, like, shoot back. And then my bottom knee comes in. He's not going to just try to flee from here. He's going to pressure in, and that's when we're going to look to bump him over and then get into our single legged X again. Alright? And then from here is where you got to make those choices here. So a couple things can happen here, right? His weight can come up on top of me. Alright? That's when we would switch to an X guard, a reverse X, bump him on his hand, and get into that honey hole position, right? But a lot of times when they try to flee, that's when we're looking for this. Boom. Alright, now we come back here. Does that make sense? Alright? Just remember, real time, bad boy starts to spin faster than you to get out, so you gotta be aware and ready for that spin. Alright? Especially if you're gonna use your knees to expose that heel. Alright, so crossing his ankle, there is no elbow escape here anymore. I gotta get my head back. I'm in here, bottom knee comes through, he pressures in, boom. If he's trying to come up on top of me, that's when I'm going to have to switch here, alright? I can go here, alright? We're talking about him stepping that way, and then eventually go into that crisscross option, alright? Or you can even switch this into backside kick, 50, alright? All that extra fun stuff in the back there, so. We'll start diving deep into that stuff in a bit once we start hammering some of these escapes. Alright, so, one more time. It's just a hard bridge now, alright? His feet are crossed. Pop. Boom, bottom knee comes through. And then I'm right into it. Boom. Make sense? Back and forth, we're gonna go live in a little bit. Ready, one, two? We're gonna get some more rest in. I'm just gonna change the direction now. And then from here is where it's going to change, right? Because instead of him being able to, like, maybe he decided to run, and maybe instead now he decided to come into me. And this is where we're going to switch into our X guard, right? So he has, like, not one dimensional world. There you go. This side can do it for sure. Other side, you'll see. Right? So, once he decides to start pressuring in, I want to switch my legs here. He starts to pressure, I'm going to start to elevate here, and then right here, I inserted my leg wrong. I actually want my top leg in front of his knee. This is how you know if you're in reverse X. My left foot's in front of the knee, reverse X. If my foot is hooking the hip, we're in the traditional X guard here. We want a reverse X, like this. So that way, as I bring him up, now I can go ahead and get into my honey hole position from here. Alright? If for some reason, maybe the entry, we didn't have control of this top leg and he steps over the head, that's when we can control the opposite leg. I'm going to hook and look at my back leg here. Feed it in and we're going to go into an X guard here. And if you didn't feel comfortable with that, you can always just shoot in into backside 50-50. Either one. Again, this is advanced class, so should be able to get to one of those at least. Boom, we're here. I see him coming. I get into my reverse X. Bam. Catch. He steps over. Crisscross S. Or backside. One more time. This is why I stand up real quick. For the advanced guys, anytime we're doing those Ashi drills, my right hand helping me out here. I extend, look at my right leg, it doesn't do anything. My right leg is that wedge leg. I'm just extending my left leg, catching with the opposite hand, crossing my ankles, bringing my heels to the mat. He steps over, I follow with that hook, I feed my foot on the inside, I can just do extend here. Whoop. Oh, and then he's done for me. Got it, back and forth for a little bit, then we're gonna go live. Everyone two!
Yeah.
out.